Can you retrieve the question, Punya? What is the question we have discussed there? Sanya, you asked the doubt, isn't it? How to make it as continuous?
Calculate the mean deviation about the median for the given table.
Okay, yeah, yes. The given data was not continuous. The given data, the data given was not continuous. Mohammad Adil, today I was saying, sir, that you are not not attending the class regularly. Emmanuel, switch on your video. Okay. Chain only other. Okay. I think we can start with this. So the question that they given was, it is not made continuous, isn't it? It is given in the form, intervals are 16 to 20, 21 to 25, 26 to 30, 31 to 35, 36 to 40, 41 to 45, 46 to 50, then 51 to 55. Children, whenever you are given intervals, and when if it is mean, median, or what about the next thing we are going to learn is standard deviation and all. Okay, if it is not continuous, first we should make it just continuous. If the interval is not continuous, first make it just continuous. Okay, first you should make it just continuous. For making it continuous, what is the difference here? Look at the gap. Here it is 21 and this is 20. So the difference is 1. So what is half of 1? What is 1 by 2? Half of 1 is 0.5, isn't it? So you add 0.5 to the upper limit and subtract 0.5 from the lower limits. So when you subtract 0.5 from the lower limit, you will get 15.5 to 20.5. 20.5 to 25.5. Sanya, is it okay? What is the difference here? It is 1, half of, find half of that, 0.5. Subtract 0.5 from the lower limit, add 0.5 to the upper limit. So again, this one will become 25.5 to 30.5. 30.5 to 35.5. 35.5 to 40.5. Now 40.5 to 45.5. Now 45.5 to 50.5 to 55.5. So this is the interval given. And what about the numbers? Numbers already it is given as 5, 6, 12, 14, 26, 12, 16, and 9. Isn't it? Is it correct? Achyut? This is the frequency given, isn't it?
Yes,
to find the median, we'll be finding the cumulative frequency. Okay, so what is the cumulative frequency? 5, 5 plus 6, 11, 11 plus 12, 23. Is it correct? Achyut, is it correct?
Yes, ma'am.
63 plus 12, 75, 75 plus 16, 91. Is it 100? Is it correct, Achyut?
Yes, ma'am.
Then after finding this, what you will do? We will find n by 2. Okay, we'll be finding n by 2. So n by 2 is 50. So which is your median class? Find it. Which one will be your median class? Where this 50 will lie? Which is your median class? Ashwin Binel. Which is your median class?
Yes, ma'am.
Which is the median class here? N by 2, you got as 50. So which is the median class? From the cumulative frequency.
40.5.
Is it 35.5 to 40.5. Okay. So what is the lower limit you have to take, Punya?
35.5.
So, and this is the cumulative frequency. This is the frequency. Okay, so lower limit is 35.5. Some of you have taken this one. Okay, this one we will not be using at all. Once we made the intervals continuous, that interval only we have to use. We'll not use this one. Now, cumulative frequency, everything is given. Now, find out the median. What is the formula for finding median? Atul, median is given by?
N plus N by 2 minus CF by F into H.
By F into H. So by applying this formula, what is the median you got? Median is? Median will be 38. Once you find the median, then again, it will be coming back to the tabular column. You find out what is modulus of xi minus m. So you have to find out xi. How will you find xi? For this interval only you have to find. We can neglect this one because it is not continuous. We don't want this. Only this one you have to use. So from here you find out what is xi, then find out what is xi minus m. After that, what you have to find? The next column is fi into xi minus m. Then here, sigma fi into xi minus m. Here you find out what is sigma fi. Sigma fi will be 100. Then apply the formula. Okay? Was it okay? I think that making this interval went wrong. Few of you didn't make this interval as continuous. And some of them have made this interval continuous. But what happens when you select the interval? When you select the lower limits, you are selecting from here, 36 to 40. Okay, once you made the interval continuous, you have to use that interval, not this one. Okay? Then you find what is the mean deviation. Okay, these are the common mistakes I found when I corrected that paper. And few of you did well. My pouch should take. Okay. So this is how we are finding the mean deviation. Okay. So do the correction and try to complete that question. Most okay, about few of you have done that one correctly. If you did the mistake. Michael, are you trying? Did you get the answer that day? What is the answer? I think Nandana and all got the answer correct. Gauri, what is the answer? I think that day you are not
7.3. 7 points.
Is it 7? Nandana, what is the answer?
Yes, ma'am, 7.35.
Okay. Then okay, Gauri, it's correct. I'm remembering that is 37 points something. Okay. 7 points. Okay. So in the next topic. Okay, after that, okay, tomorrow in the next class, be ready again for the test paper. One question, you have to solve it and we'll be evaluating. Okay, today what you are learning, the next day, be ready for the test paper. Okay, the thing we are learning is, what you are learning? What is the formula we wrote? We have learned four formulas. Standard deviation and variance, isn't it? Standard deviation and variance. For the standard deviation and variance, four formulas were there. The first one is for discrete data. We are using standard deviation and variance. 50 as a measure of dispersion only, but here instead of taking modulus, magnitude, we are squaring it. So in the first case, for the discrete data, standard deviation and variance is given by sigma xi minus x bar the whole square. Yes or no? What is the first formula there? Diya, give the first formula for the discrete data. Variance is given by
sigma xi minus x dash whole square by x.
By n. N. Okay, or sigma xi outright. N is total number. Okay, here x, not x dash, it is x bar. X bar. Mean, we denote it as x bar. Okay, so now let's do one question right on. Find the variance of the following data. Variance is 33. So next one, find the variance and standard deviation for the following. Again, two columns are given, xi and fi. Xi, it is given as 4, 8, 11, 17, 20, 24, 32. Fi is given. Fi is given as 3, 5, 9, 5, 4, 3, 1. So tell me, children, here which formula you have to use here for standard deviation? Xi and Fi are given. What is the formula? Nandana.
Sigma Fi into Xi minus X bar the whole square by N.
Xi minus X bar the whole square by N. N means it is same as sigma Fi. So we want to find X bar. Okay, this is sigma square. So we want to find X bar. What is sigma X bar? In our frequencies are given sigma Fi Xi by sigma Fi. So find the next one, Fi into Xi. Fi into Xi, which is 12, 40, 99, 17 into 5 is 85, 80, 72, 32. Now find out what is sigma Fi Xi. Find out what is sigma Fi. What is sigma Fi Xi? What is sigma Fi? Yes. What is sigma Fi Xi? Finish, children. What is sigma fi xi, Gauri?
I got 420.
420. What about Punya? Is it 420?
Yes, ma'am.
Ashwin Binil, what is sigma fi? Ashwin?
Yes, ma'am.
What is sigma?
One minute.
Sigma fi.
1 minute. Sigma fi 30, ma'am.
30. So, what will be x bar? So, you find x bar. X bar is 420 by 30. Rijas, what is x bar? Rijas. What will be x bar?
14.
14. So, once you find 14, the next column you can write is xi minus x bar. Then find out what is xi minus x bar, the whole square. Then fi into xi minus x bar, the whole square. Fi into xi minus x bar, the whole square. X bar is 14. So x bar is 14. So xi minus x bar. So 4 minus 14. So this negative 10, so you'll get 100. 8 minus 14, it is minus 6, minus 3, 3, then 6, 10, 18, square it. So 36, 9, 9, 36, 100, 324. Now find out what is fi into xi minus x bar, the whole square. Up to this, is it over? Emmanuel, be ready to give the answers. Emmanuel, find fi into xi minus x bar, the whole square, and give the answer. Is it ready? So, what is fi into xi minus x bar, the whole square? Emmanuel. Emmanuel. Yes, Emmanuel. What is fi into xi minus x bar, the whole square? So this, these two things you have to multiply, isn't it? What is that? Krishna Chandran, tell me, Krishna Chandran, what is fi into xi minus x bar, the whole square?
300.
No, first one is 300. The next one?
180.
180.
81.
81.
45.
45.
144.
144.
300.
300.
324.
324. Okay. Others check. Is it correct? Shivani, tell me what is sigma fi into xi minus x bar the whole square. Sigma fi into xi minus x bar the whole square. Sigma means you have to add up all those things, isn't it? When you add this, what you will get? Shivani.
Doing.
Do it and give the answer.
1374.
So those who got this, find complete, find the variance and find the standard deviation. Take the square root. Okay, long division method. Use long division method and find the square root.
Ma'am, 1374.
1374. Okay. So once you find this, what is sigma square? Calculate it. What is sigma square? 1374 by 30. Is it correct, Achyut?
Ma'am, I'm still doing.
Okay. So after finding sigma square, you have to find what is sigma. What is 1374 by 30? Atul?
45.8.
Then you have to take square root of 45.8. That will give sigma, standard deviation. What is the answer, Michael? Are you getting the sigma square and all? Which one you are doing now, Michael?
Yeah, I'm doing it.
Which one? This one, is it over? Variance, is it over? 6.767. Okay. It is approximately 6.7. Nandana, finish. What the answer?
Yes, ma'am.
6.7.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What about Naureen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Aditya? Finished?
No, ma'am.
Doing?
I wrote 6.9 something.
6.9. Okay, let's see that one. How to find the square root? Those who don't know, check. We ought to find the square root of 45.8, isn't it? What you will do? We'll make it pair. Okay, before the decimal, we have to pair. Here also, we have only 1 8 is there, so I put 0 here. So which is the largest perfect square contained in 45? 6 6 are 36, isn't it? You subtract it, we'll get 9. Is it correct? Then dot we have, so you put dot, take the next pair down, 18. 6, when you double it, you will get 12. Okay, here using which number you are going to fill, with the same number you will multiply. Suppose I multiply, take it 5 here, means 5 5s are 25, 10, 12, 6, 25, it is very small. So we can take with the next option. Suppose I'm taking 7, let's take this one. 7 7s are 49, 7 2s are 14, 14 plus 4 is 8, 889, is it correct? If I take 8, I think it will exceed. Suppose I take 128 into 8, 8 8s are 64, 16 plus 6 is 22, so I'll get 1000 something, which is exceeding. So possibility is 7. So 889, and you subtract this, this is 1, 980 minus 89. So is it 9? So 91, is it correct? Then you'll add 2 zeros. Add 2 zeros. Now double the 67. When you double the 67, what you will get? 134. Is it correct? 134. Suppose I might fill this here with 5. 1, 3, 4. If I fill 5, 25, 22, 7, 6, 7, 2, 5, which is very smaller. So let's take. Okay. Let's take this with, suppose I fill this with 7. 7 7s are 49, 28, 32, 3, 21. 7 3s are 21, 22, 23. So it will exceed. So only possibility is 9.76. 6.76. Approximation, you can do it. So it is 6.76. Okay, Aditya, is it clear? Write the next one, children. Next one. Find the mean variance and standard deviation. Find the mean variance and standard deviation for the following. Find the mean variance and standard deviation for the following. Thirty to forty, thirty to fifty, fifty to sixty, sixty to seventy, seventy to eighty, eighty to ninety. 9200. So interval is given. Then frequency 3, 7, 12, 15, 8, 3, 2. So classes are given, intervals are given, and frequency are given. Listen, children. Intervals, is it continuous? Is it continuous here? Yeah.
Yes.
Continuous. Yes. Listen, if you learn, okay, this, whenever we are given intervals, we can do the find the variance and mean, yes, using the same formula we can do the previous one, sigma fi into xi minus x bar the whole square by sigma fi. Using this one, you can do We know how to find xi. How will you find xi? What is xi? What is xi? Upper limits plus lower limits by 2. Okay. So we can use this formula and we can find. So you find xi, you find, okay, find xi minus x bar the whole square and complete this question before the next period using this formula. Using this formula, okay, you find out what is xi, x bar. Okay, how will you find xi? Michael, how will you find xi? Upper limit plus lower limit by 2, isn't it? So this one will become 35, 45. So find out what is xi. Then find out what is x bar. Apply the formula and be ready with the answer before the next maths class. Okay, next class we can continue with this one.
Ma'am.
Yes, Achut.
Ma'am, I did not finish the question. So can you just show, I take the screenshot.
Okay, complete the mean, find the mean and be ready. Is it okay, Achut?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, children. So you can meet in the next class. Thank you.